Hello and welcome to the next instalment of Vinnie Plays Portal 2. At the end of the last episode, I put the stupid robot in charge and GLaDOS got implanted into a potato, and then we fell down a really long way, and then she got stolen by a bird of some description, if I remember rightly. And other than that, I'm not really sure what's going on. So, we fell down. Okay, we must be going this way. The audio is so good in this game. Not that way, clearly. Must be this way. Keep out. Do not enter. Condemned testing area. That sounds interesting. Warning, this environment, this enrichment shaft, I should really put my glasses on, may contain unsafe quantities of cosmic ray spallation elements. Do not enter. Are those walls I can shoot onto? Really don't want me to come in here, do they? Going on here? A vault of some description. Do not enter, sealed. 15th of June 1961. Yeah, some sort of control room. There. So I've got to press both buttons within that time, I think. Thank you. just got there in time. Open. What the hell are we going to find in here? Essentially a fire door. This is where it turns into the Stanley Parable. Let's consume some alcohol. This evening's beverage is TEA by the Hogsback Brewery. Muddy water. Do not need a railing. I do what I want. Shake there. Some shit's falling down. Where are we up to go here? Obviously, all this wall is shootable. So I've got to go through here, have I? Some sort of space race-esque science project by the looks of things. And I've got to get up there, I would think. That's probably close to run to. Oh shit. Maybe I haven't got to be up here. Maybe I do. Maybe I've got to get over there. Okay, let's go back down for a second and just work out exactly where I need to go. Entry is there. If I was to jump out of there, would that be right, maybe? Drop onto there, fire another blue portal, and perhaps splat directly into the wall? Who knows? Might be too high, but we'll give it a whirl. Not gonna make it. No fall damage though. That angle, aren't I? drop off of that and onto there. That's easy enough, actually. Oh, through the hole as well.
There's amazing. 1,000 tests performed every day here in our enrichment spheres. I can't personally oversee every one of them, so these pre-recorded messages will cover any questions you might have and respond to any incidents that may occur in the course of your science adventure. Your test assignment will vary depending on the manner in which you have bent the world to your will. Those of you helping us test the repulsion gel today, just follow the blue line on the floor. Those of you who volunteered to be injected with praying mantis DNA, I've got some good news and some bad news. Bad news is we're postponing those tests indefinitely. Good news is we've got a much better test for you, fighting an army of mantis men. Pick up a rifle and follow the yellow line. You'll know when the test starts.
That sounds like fun. You'll know when the test starts. Going up, first floor, men's wear. Gotta get over there. So can't be falling down there, because that'd be ridiculous. So where have I got to go? How about this piece of wall here, that'll do.
Just a heads up, we're gonna have a superconductor turned up full blast and pointed at you for the duration of this next test. I'll be honest, we're throwing science at the wall here to see what sticks. No idea what it'll do. Probably nothing. Best case scenario, you might get some superpowers. Worst case, some tumors, which we'll cut out.
Let's see where Glados gets it from.
Just a heads up, we're gonna have a superconductor turned up full blast and pointed at you. If you need to go to the bathroom after this next series of tests, please let a test associate know, because in all likelihood, whatever comes out of you is going to be coal. Only temporary, so do not worry. If it persists for a week, though, start worrying and come see us, because that's not supposed to happen. If you've cut yourself at all in the course of these tests, you might have noticed that your blood is pure gasoline. That's normal. We've been shooting you with an invisible laser that's supposed to turn blood into gasoline, so all that means is it's working.
Okay, I like this dude already. Can't really work out where I'm supposed to be going, though. Let's head back down there. I'm going to workstation Alpha, but how the hell am I going to get there? I need to put the lift back down and then jump into the shaft and fly over there, perhaps. That sounds possible. We'll just do it that way. Let's do that. Victory! Well, that didn't take me too long. KP will be proud. Pressure control. talk about some sort of gel a second ago. Myself in the blue door. Any more uneasy messages to listen to? No. Okay. So we're not going that way. We're walking down the pond.
They say great science is built on the shoulders of giants. Not here. At Aperture, we do all our science from scratch. No hand-holding.
Okay, into the room. Stroke area. Wonder what this gel stuff does.
Started. This first test involves something the lab boys call repulsion gel. You're not part of the control group, by the way. You get the gel. Last poor son of a gun got blue paint. All joking aside, that did happen. Broke every bone in his legs. Tragic, but informative. Or so I'm told.
Remember, this test is unsolvable without an aperture science. Portable quantum tone device. If you have not received one, please find a test circuit before participating in any of Shaft 9 enrichment activities. Well, as luck would have it, I do have one. Repulsion gel was Aperture's first attempt to create a dietetic pudding substitute. It is true, the gel is a sweeter, slightly less non-toxic form of fiberglass insulation that causes subsequently ingested food items to bounce off the lining of a dieter's distended stomach and out his or her mouth for various reasons. And unfortunately, this product was pulled from shelves. So it's basically, it's bouncy. Okay, that's cool. 360. Can't make a portal through it. Okay, so whatever force you put in, you get out. That's interesting.
The lab boys just informed me that I should not have mentioned the control group.
They're telling me I ought to stop making these pre-recorded messages. That gave me an idea. Make more pre-recorded messages. I pay the bills here, I can talk about the control group all damn day.
I expect some very interesting puzzles with that stuff. Probably, but we'll just double check if anything is in this direction. Yeah. Little room with absolutely nothing of any interest. Thanks, Valve.
For this next test, we put nanoparticles in the gel. In layman's terms, that's a billion little gizmos that are going to travel into your bloodstream and pump experimental genes and RNA molecules and so forth into your tumors. Now, maybe you don't have any tumors. Well, don't worry. If you sat on a folding chair in the lobby and weren't wearing lead underpants, we took care of that too.
This stuff is cool. Wait for that thing to come back. You tit. Come back. Oh. Weird. To bounce onto that through the blue thing. That's what I need to do. I'm thinking about this way too much. Okay. Boing.
Okay.
So that's just death. So I need to jump on this on an angle. That's win. Boing, boing.
Oh, in case you got covered in that repulsion gel, here's some advice the lab boys gave me. Do not get covered in the repulsion gel. We haven't entirely nailed down what element it is yet, but I'll tell you this, it's a lively one, and it does not like the human skeleton.
Too late. Certainly interesting having something to think about other than just the portals. The surface you're bouncing on is an interesting mechanic.
All these science spheres are made of asbestos, by the way. Keeps out the rats. Let us know if you feel a shortness of breath, a persistent dry cough, or your heart stopping, because that's not part of the test. That's asbestos. Good news is the lab boys say the symptoms of asbestos poisoning show a median latency of 44.6 years. So if you're 30 or older, you're laughing. Worst case scenario, you miss out on a few rounds of canasta. Plus, you forwarded the cause of science by 3 centuries. I punch those numbers into my calculator, it makes a happy face.
This chap is definitely the father and creator of GLaDOS. These are portal surfaces. Maybe up there.
Your style. You make up your own rules, just like me. Bean Counter said I couldn't fire a man just for being in a wheelchair. Did it anyway. Ramps are expensive.
Where have I got to move that to get out? That is not abundantly clear. Chance I didn't really look. So is that out there? Yeah. Over here as well. So I'm going to need some more of that stuff. See what happens. Oh yeah.
Just a heads up, that coffee we gave you earlier had fluorescent calcium in it, so we can track the neuronal activity in your brain. There's a slight chance the calcium could harden and vitrify your frontal lobe. Anyway, don't stress yourself thinking about it. I'm serious. Visualizing the scenario while under stress actually triggers the reaction.
Manipulating that gel stuff, awesome. Love this. Was hoping there'd be a few twists on the standard portal mechanics from the first game. Finally got some. About 4 hours in.
Now, if you're part of control group Kepler 7, we implanted a tiny microchip about the size of a postcard into your skull. Most likely you've forgotten it's even there. But if it starts vibrating and beeping during this next test, let us know. Because that means it's about to hit 500 degrees, so we're going to need to go ahead and get that out of you pretty fast.
Right. See if I can stop this. And I haven't got enough momentum to get over there, have I? So how am I going to do that? Like that. Jump onto that. And then go. Oh, I didn't notice that there though, did I? more observant. That's my first major fuck up.
I'm telling them, keep your pants on. All right, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel. So, word of advice, if you meet yourself on the testing track, don't make eye contact. Lab boys tell me that'll wipe out time. Entirely. Forward and backward. So, do both of yourselves a favor and just let that handsome devil go about his business.
Not really sure where I'm meant to be going here. That's the room I was in earlier. Up there. So I got to bring some gel with me. Looks that way. Get in. Right. That was so useful that it doesn't appear to be the way. Unless I'm missing something really obvious. Which again is entirely possible. No? That was the doorway there.
If you're hearing this, it means you're taking a long time on the catwalk between tests. The lab boys say that might be a fear reaction. I'm no psychiatrist, but coming from a bunch of eggheads who wouldn't recognize the thrill of danger if it walked up and snapped their little pink bras, that sounds like projection. They didn't fly into space, storm a beach, or bring back the gold. No, sir, we did. It's you and me against the world, son. I like your grit. Hustle could use some work, though. Now let's solve this thing.
Right, so I need that cube. So I think I'm gonna have to fill it with water. No? Does that not top it up? No. I'm not covered. Yes. Bouncy cube is out. That was a damn thing. Go and wash it off. Otherwise it'll never sit on that button. Not if I don't put it on there securely.
science isn't about why, it's about why not. Why is so much of our science dangerous? Why not marry safe science if you love it so much? In fact, why not invent a special safety door that won't hit you on the butt on the way out because you are fire? Now you test subject, you're doing fine. Yes, you, box your stuff, out the front door, parking lot, car, goodbye.
Sounds like such an understanding boss. Many of GLaDOS's traits are clearly inherited from this fine gentleman, Cave Johnson.
Congratulations! The simple fact that you're standing here listening to me means you've made a glorious contribution to science. As founder and CEO of Aperture Science, I thank you for your participation and hope we can count on you for another round of tests. We're not going to release this stuff into the wild until it's good and damn ready, so as long as you keep yourself in top physical form, there will always be a limo waiting for you. Say goodbye, Carolyn.
Goodbye, Carolyn.
She is a gem.
Goodbye, Carolyn. Apart from the door is blocked. Station beta. Is there some sort of lever I should be pushing or pulling? Clearly where I need to be. Is there any other way? Can't get back out. Gonna have to drop onto it from somewhere to get the momentum. There's no gel or anything I can use in here. Yeah, so if I drop from there, drop into there. Okay, I need to just move the blue portal once I'm through this one. That was the wrong one. Okay, let's try that again. Go through this one, then move the orange one up onto that thing. Oh, not quite high enough. Where the hell am I? Looking at the floor, like a tit. Use the shit out of me, that. Okay. Both of those up and running. The door is open. We'll head up to this control room by the looks of things.
Greetings, friend. I'm Cave Johnson, CEO of Aperture Science. You might know us as a vital participant in the 1968 Senate hearings on missing astronauts. And you've most likely used one of the many products we invented, but that other people have somehow managed to steal from us. Black Mesa can eat my bankrupt...
Sir, the testing?
Right. Now you might be asking yourself, Cave, just how difficult are these tests? What was in that phone book of a contract I signed? Am I in danger? Let me answer those questions with a question. Who wants to make $60? Cash. You can also feel free to relax for up to 20 minutes in the waiting room, which is a damn sight more comfortable than the park benches most of you were sleeping on when we found you. So, welcome to Aperture. You're here because we want the best, and you're it. Nope, couldn't keep a straight face. Anyway, don't smudge up the glass down there. In fact, why don't you just go ahead and not touch anything unless it's test-related.
Let's touch everything, even if it isn't test-related. Okay, there doesn't seem to be much going on in here, actually. Retro computers in here, the old tapes. Remember, if you see an orange jumpsuit, hit the red button. That's curious. I don't think this is where I want to be. No, it isn't. Luckily I knew where I was then. So I need to be higher. So I need to go from there, maybe.
Oh, hi. Say, you're good at murder. Could you murder this bird for me? Oh, thanks. Did you feel that? That idiot doesn't know what he's doing up there. This whole place is going to explode in a few hours if somebody doesn't disconnect him. I can't move, and unless you're planning to saw your own head off and wedge it into my old body, you're going to need me to replace him. We're at an impasse. So what do you say? You carry me up to him and put me back into my body, and I stop us from blowing up and let you go. Ow! You stabbed me! What is wrong with Do you have a multimeter? Never mind. The gun must be part magnesium. It feels like I'm outputting an extra half a volt.
Right, now we try that jump. We've rescued our potato. I'm glad we're reunited with her. Let's see if the fat jokes are slightly lessened now that
did anything happen while I was out?
She's in a potato. Yes, it did. The end of this episode happened, Glados. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you for another episode very soon.